warm welcome from the Lake Placid Ski Jumping Centre, where the first event of the Nordic Combined Competition is about to get underway. It's the individual Gundersen, and so the results here will decide the starting order for tonight's cross-country race. And this is how they line up. The women will go first. We've got a total of 25 athletes competing, 19 in the men's, 6 in the women's. Three countries have sent athletes into the women's competition. Some Japanese flags flying. And if the predictions are correct, then those Japanese fans will have plenty to celebrate by the end of the day. So here we go with our first jumper, Ayane Miyazaki of Japan. 20-year-old from Nagano gets us underway here at the Lake Placid Fizu Winter Games. And it's a nice jump. The judges, remember, looking for technique as well as distance. Looked a little bit further than that to me. So she was just inside the distance there and gets 97.9 points. So remember the K point, as we call it, is where you, if it's that one of those red lines, if you hit that, you get your 60 points. And then every meter beyond that, you get extra points. So Joanna Kill of Poland,
all right, Joanna's got a really nice looking at
nice takeoff, good push up from the legs, and a telemark landing. They have to land in a certain way, in a certain style, known as the telemark landing. You see the push off. And that's why strength and power in the legs is so important.
You can put your hand right on me.
And that's got a 78 meter distance. That's put Joanna Kill of Poland in second place. Haruka Kasai, one of two twins here. Her sister Yuna will go straight after her. And that's the go.
Really nice looking, stable in run position, and a big
nice style, solid. So it'd be interesting to see how the judges score that. I think that might make the difference. She got 86 meters. So short of the K point. But it was good enough, 114 points. That puts her top of the pile. So our final jumper in the women's competition is Yuna Kasai, 18 years old. So the green light is on. They have 10 seconds to launch themselves once the green light goes on. That's what she's done. Right ski slightly off to one side, but she brought it back. Solid landing. Now, distance was 80 meters. So 80 meters is well under what she jumped in the training runs earlier on today. But what do the judges make of her style? She's got herself 100.5 points. That is a good score, and that puts her in second place. So that concludes the women's round of the individual Gundersen. That's confirmation of the results. Wow, Japan first, second and third, Poland in fourth, Sana Azagami of Japan in fifth, and Tess Arnone in sixth place. So the women are done, and we move on to the men's individual Gundersen now. They have a 10-kilometre cross-country race to compete for tonight, but where they start will depend on the results of this jump. 19 men in total, representing 6 countries. On to Sakutaro Kobayashi of Japan. He jumped the furthest in training earlier, so there are a lot of expectations on him right now. He's the oldest, most experienced competitor here, 22 years old. Can he pull it out of the bag again? Nice launch, nice style, solid, and a good landing. And he knows he's done well. 100 meters distance, the furthest jumper by far, and it's going to be difficult to catch that. And look at the points, 138.6. That's 32 points ahead of his nearest competitor. That's extraordinary. Right, home fans have come to check out this guy, Evan Nichols of the USA from Lake Placid. Nice fluid launch. Distance 88.5. The judges, though, like the style. So the judging points will bring him up, will help that shorter distance. And we'll see his total points, 107.3. That's excellent for Evan Nichols. Studies at the Community College of Vernon. And to help you understand the significance of, you know, every meter and every point, every 15 points at the end will count as a minute handicap at the start of the cross-country race. Rasmus Atava lands on his jump. Finnish team looking strong once again after a while in the doldrums. Good distance, 92 meters has been confirmed. Good style. So he will finish quite well up the leaderboard, I think, when we get his points confirmed. Yeah, 104.5, that puts the Finn into fourth place. So our last jumper is Niklas Malasinski of the USA, 19-year-old. Silver medalist in the Junior Worlds last year. Waiting to get his one jump in. It's brutal rules, isn't it? You mess up your jump and it messes up the whole competition for you.
Looks like it's locked and loaded.
Nice control through the air. But was it a long enough jump? Probably not. 82 meters. Mostly 16, 16.5 are coming through from the judges. But look, he looks in control, doesn't he? And that's what the judges are looking for. Good positioning, good flight, good control. And that gives him a total of 100.8. And that puts Niklas Malasinski of the USA into seventh place. And there we go. Sakutaro Kobayashi of Japan will have a huge advantage of 2 minutes and 5 seconds in the cross country. At second, Evan Nichols of the USA. Third, Matej Fadrons. He put in a great jump for the Czech Republic. So the first stage in the individual Gundersen is complete. Two and a half kilometres twice is what the women will have to complete. You'd expect the two twin sisters, Haruka Kasai and Yuna Kasai, to head off and race their own race, 54 seconds between them. And the first skier is off. Haruka Kasai, representing Japan, sprints off the start line with a 54-second advantage, and she's got to make the most of it.
This is a long break. It's a hard work. Probably going to be at least 13 or 14 minutes.
18-year-old Yuna Kasai starts her cross-country lap. Japanese athlete holding silver medal position, Ayane Miyazaki, just a few seconds behind, is our leader, making her lonely road through the race, through this track. But Tess Arnone didn't have the best of jumps earlier on today, gets her race underway finally. Now for her, it's very much a race for pride, show what she can do. Leader out in front, untroubled. Fast enough to get into a squat. So very little time difference between the two leading women. In fact, it's almost exactly as they started. Miyazaki has reached the first intermediate stage, a minute 28 behind, so she's lost time on the leader. Joanna Kill of Poland, 2 minutes, 2 seconds behind, so no change there. So here comes our leader back into the stadium, one lap almost completed already. Seen plenty of Japanese support in this Nordic combined. They were out at the ski jump, and now we can hear the Japanese fans supporting their athletes. This is Ayane Miyazaki coming in to the grandstand now towards the stadium finish. Second lap, this is where it starts getting tough. This is where you start feeling the muscles, where you start screaming for breath, but Kasai just needs to keep up the pace. The time difference coming into the stadium between Haruka and Yuna is pretty much how they started the race. Yuna Kasai trying desperately to close the gap on her sister, but it hasn't changed since the start of the race. So. But positions at the moment, Haruka Kasai, Yuna Kasai, Miyazaki of Japan, so it remains Japan 1-2-3. Then comes Kill of Poland and Arnone of the USA. As we focus on our leading athlete, and Haruka Kasai comes into the stadium and begins to get closer and closer, begins the run-in to the finish line, her compatriots and the other women. But here we are, the first gold medal in the Nordic combined goes to Haruka Kasai of Japan with an absolutely dominant performance, both in the ski jumping and in the cross country. The other Kasai into the stadium now, you can see she's beginning to hurt. She knows it's just a few seconds to the finish, and Yuna Kasai sprints to the finish line to take silver in the individual Gundersen. And that is gold and silver to the Kasai twin sisters, the 18-year-old bright stars of Japanese Nordic combined. Now, we're going to have a third place finish for Japan as well. But look at that, how close is the pole, Joanna Kill. Can Miyazaki keep that distance? It looks like she's going to be good as she sprints to the finish line. The last few meters are going to be hers. And it's bronze for Japan and Ayane Miyazaki. But what a brave finish from Joanna Kill. And they're arranging themselves conveniently into a podium position. With Haruka in the middle, our gold medalist, Yuna, her sister, takes silver. And the 20-year-old from Nagano, Ayane Miyazaki, takes the bronze medal. Time for the men's individual Gundersen. It
It's a 10-kilometer cross-country race in the Nordic combined. Kobayashi is going to be very difficult to catch. He has a 2-minute, 5-second advantage, but I can tell you that the top nine are all in with a really good chance. As Sakataro Kobayashi starts this race with a 2-minute, 5-second advantage. And barring disaster, that's a fall or an injury or breaking a ski, I think the gold medal is already in his pocket. The competitor from the USA, Evan Nichols, is away. Straight behind him, the Czech Republic's Matej Fadrons. Rasmus Ataba, Vitaly Rebnyuk of Ukraine. Andrzej Szewczukowicz of Poland. There is calmness personified, our leader. No pressure, just has to race his race, really. Second and third, this is where the big battle is, with Rasmus Ataba in fourth, just on their shoulders as they come up this first slope. And only now have the chasers reached that intermediate point. They're 2 minutes and 9 seconds back. So the time differences have remained stable from the start. But our leader, Kobayashi, completes his first lap and heads out again for lap number two. But here we are. The battle that is ensuing behind the leader, and you can see that 6, 7 and 8 have now, and 5 have now caught and closed that gap. So this is really close. We've got number 7, Niklas Malasinski of the USA coming forward. So are we going to see some team tactics here between the American athletes? So 16 minutes at this mark, and 6.4 for Kobayashi. That's a good time. 6 athletes chasing 2 medals, a silver and a bronze. Matej Fadrons of the Czech Republic drop back now. But here comes the leader back into the stadium for the third time. Look at the time differences. The gap between him and the chasing pack is just not coming down. Here comes the pack of 6. They begin their descent towards the stadium. Ataba still out in front. Calm as always. The leader knows he has this race in the bag. The chasers have managed to shave a few seconds off Kobayashi's advantage. So here comes Sakutaro Kobayashi of Japan. He was great on the ski jumping, and he's managed to hold the advantage through the cross-country skiing as well. It's gold for Japan, their second gold in the Nordic combined after the women's success earlier in the day. Yeah. And it looks like it's going to be Malasinski of the USA. Yep, the athlete from Steamboat Springs, Colorado Mountain College. comes up to the finish line, and having fought with the rest of the pack for every meter and every bit of space, he does it. He takes silver for the USA. And Malasinski's half finish, well, Matej Fadrons is also in the mix. But Rasmus Otava of Finland takes third. Confirmation of the results and the medals. It's gold to Japan and Sakutaro Kobayashi. Nicholas Malasinski in the end of the USA takes second, with Rasmus Otava in third.
Please welcome the winners. Tonight, the mascots will be presented by DeWint on behalf of Mount Vent Hovenberg. In place, representing Japan, Anya Miyazaki. In second place, representing Japan, Yuna Kazai. And in first place, for the women's individual Gunderson 5-kilometer cross-country ski race, representing Japan, Haruka Kazai.
Confirmation of the medals. It's gold for Haruka Kasai. Her sister Yuna takes silver, and Ayane Miyazaki will celebrate the bronze medal tonight.
In third place, representing Finland, Rasmus Otava. In second place, representing the United States of America, Nicholas Malasinski. And in first place in the men's individual Gunderson 10-kilometer cross-country ski race, the champion representing Japan, Sakuturo Kobayashi. The Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games winners.
Victory for Sakutaro Kobayashi confirmed there with the gold medal. Nicholas Malasinski of the USA coming from behind to take silver, and Rasmus Otava of Finland taking third place.